My question will be in Odia, and the people, particularly Dr. Mahapatra, can better answer it. Ayush, Bishesh Bhavare Ayurveda, ra pracharo prasar tatha aushadhiya brukhyalata gulmo ra sandhan gabeshana o ropan pai. Krushi udyan vibhag jungle vibhag saha milita prachesta heuchi ki. Jadi ha, tara sabishesh bibarani mu magibi. द्वितीय कथा हला भारत केते मूल्य आयुर्वेदिक औषध विदेश को रप्तानी करुची एक कथा पचार उद्देश्य होची आम माने जहां सब कहू थाए गोटे हला सर्जिकल एवं आउट हला मेडिसिन एंड केयर जो हम कहू थाए ऑल आर बेस्ड ऑन एलोपैथी बट इंडिया हैज गॉट द हाईएस्ट पोटेंशियलिटी इन केस ऑफ आयुर्वेद एंड द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट डॉक्टर महापात्र हैज गिवन एंड दिस द जेंटलमैन फ्रॉम पटना मिस्टर आराध्य He has also concluded his speech also with Vasudeva Kutumbakam and the slokas. So my point is, Ayurveda is the best only answer, and we have to develop that vocal for local. Thank you.
I think it's a very important question. If you look at the Veda, Ayurveda is part of Atharva Veda. Because we understood that without good quality life, a good quality human being is not possible. So Ayurveda is one of the mother of all medicine. Most of the allopathic medicine has a herbal background, which is a final product. So we have even the allopathic medicine from the plant product. So there is no question that Ayurveda is refined to some extent to the allopathic medicine. The question is that allopathic medicine are costly, Ayurvedic cheap. Today the confidence of Ayurvedic medicine is low because allopathic medicine give you quick and long term, I think short term use and long term effect. But Ayurvedic medicine is less harmful, it has a less cost, and it may cause cure of the disease which many allopathic medicine may not give. Coming to the export of the medicine, if you go to different country, you will see Ayurvedic shops. Whether it's Australia, whether England, in many parts of the America, Dr. Das is there. Dr. he is there, he was in Australia for a long time. Ayurvedic has gone to many countries, but what you expected, there is no medical explosion in Ayurvedic. That is because of our attitude change in India and not patronization by government of India. They have started Ayush in 2005. It's a complementary medical practices to each other, so that the costly medicine can be less prescribed and people can have a long-term cure by using herbal product. But it requires a lot of mindset, attitudinal difference, and also patronization by the medical doctors and government. It's not slogan standing here, ki Ayurved. They should really do the production centers, quality control. What is more important, we all know Tulsi is good for cough and cold. Something Google is good for this. Maybe Brahmi is good for good memory. But where is the It's all right that Indian with a background of knowledge of Ayurveda or from Puran or Shastra or the books, we know that Ayurvedic is very helpful. But other countries, they don't know. You have to provide the scientific evidence. Today, to get a scientific evidence, you say, whether this was gone through field trial, phase one, phase two, phase three, you know that COVID vaccine, even knew that COVID vaccine is going to work, it has to go through the phases. So Ayurvedic medicine has not gone through a time-tested process of class one medicine, phase one trial, phase two trial, phase three trial, and long-term clinical trial with control studies. Half people get this medicine, half people admit. So when you convince the rest of the world Ayurvedic is good, you have to have scientific evidence, which is lacking today. So most of the people, those who use it in India, the conviction, experience, personal communication, rather the scientific evidence based. So if you have to tell the rest of the world, take Ayurvedic medicine, then where is the evidence? That's the most important.